Ladies and gentlemen, tonight we're going to talk about Maven and how to write custom plugins. They're also called Mojos instead of Podios, which is a plain old Java object. Then Mojo is a Maven old Java object. And we're going to create the plugin in one project, and then we're going to use it in another consumer project. And we're going through something called execution. That's the actual task or the method that we want to execute on a certain class. That's called the execution. Then we have something called phase. Which lifecycle phase do we want this to happen in? There's a lot of phases, but we will choose a phase, and then we will see our plugin being executed in the current phase. We're going to talk about configuration. How will you configure one of these plugins now that they're made? We are going to use the add parameter annotation, and we're going to use default values. And in these default values, we can use variables. That means we can, for instance, write dollar and then brackets and then write project. And then we can actually get the project injected. That means we have the whole project context injected to our plugin. And then we can ask for, let's say, the build directory that could be used or other plugins that we have activated. Stuff like that, but let us jump right into it. As usual, it's much easier to see in when you play around with the real examples. So I'm going to my weather forecast plugin. I've created this project here. I created by pressing new and then project, and then I chose Maven in the beginning, but that I was not happy with that actually, because it did not give me the right dependencies and stuff like that, which I would have expected. Oh, let me just go back to Maven down here. Then that is, we can choose create from archetype, and then I can choose somewhere down here. There is something called plugin archetype module. I chose this one to begin with, but it's using very old dependencies. I did not like this. So instead, I actually deleted all the stuff I got from in my pump file, so actually I end up with an almost empty pump file like this. The only thing that I actually used from the Mojo archetype from the new project then is actually this line here, packaging Maven plugin, because we need to package this as a Maven plugin. This is what actually will package this in the repository and place it as a Maven plugin. I will just show a small drawing before I continue. If I go here, what we're going to do is today on your own machine, you will all have a local Maven repository. It is installed by default in your, usually it's placed in the .m2 folder. So that means that then we have a repository right here. Then we have the plugin project right here, plugin. This is my IntelliJ plugin project. It's right here where I place in a lot of code. I write the pump.xml right here. And then when I choose Maven clean install, then it actually places the plugin into this local repository. And then I have my consumer down here. Consumer down here, which is another project. In this project, I'm going to set up my pump.xml so it actually uses the plugin that I just placed there. So that means that I will actually add this this plugin right there, and then I will actually maybe I'll just clean and package this one clean package, and then I will see I get some output in my console right here. Then I will see some console output that I actually defined up in my plugin up here. So this is the idea with it all. Of course, in a real life scenario, you would actually publish this plugin to an enterprise repository that you have here. Maybe you have an enterprise repository, or maybe you would have a repository. You use one of the open repositories out there if it's not if there's no secret code inside it. But that's up to you. But this is the scenario that I'm going to use right now. Plugin project, local repository, a consumer project that uses the same local repository, and then we'll get some console output that shows that everything works as it should. Let me get back to my weather forecast plugin right here. So I got this package, which is the Maven plugin right here. And the first thing that I don't like about this, if I try to run this by then by default, it will actually try to compile it and use Maven 3.2, and that will give me a lot of errors. And that's because it's partly because of the dependencies I'm using, and I think also it's partly because I'm using Java 12. But nevertheless, I actually need to say I need to choose say that actually I want to use Maven 3.4 for this demo right here. And for this, I prepared a little bit a small piece of code, or not code, but setup in my. I'm going to set the plugin version. It's actually 3.6. Sorry, it was 3.6. I'm going to use. So that means that I'm going to add a build section like this, and then I'm going to say plugins, and then this plugin here, Maven plugin. And then then I'm going to set this version here 3.6.0. If I don't add anything here, then the default would be 3.2, and that it gives a lot of problems. So add this to begin with, then you will save yourself a lot of debugging. And then I added. Then I need to add three dependencies, and they all do different stuff. In many guides out there, you will actually see that you need to add this because then you can actually have implement the Mojo. Let me just check something here. Then you can implement. Oh, sorry, then you can extend the abstract Mojo class, then because then if you have this dependency here. That's correct. And then you have this. This is the annotation, maybe plugins annotation. Then I can add annotations like add Mojo and add parameter. And then this annotation here, it gives me the possibility. It looks like it's an alpha, but it works fine. So don't be afraid to use this. This gives me the opportunity to get the project context and the settings and stuff like that for the project where it's running, and then I can use that as a variable in my plugin. And that for instance, I can use the build directory. I can get that from the parameter called project, etc. But I'll show you all this. But nevertheless, add these three dependencies here. Some of the guides out there, they don't have this dependency here, and then they don't use complex. Then it's not a complex example. Then it's maybe a basic example where you just use some strings to configure your plugin. But if you want the context, the project context, etc., add this plugin also. Just add all three. Then you have all the possibilities that you need, all the options. Let me just check. There is one more thing. I like to say that it's explicitly say that it's actually Java 12 that I'm using. So I add this properties section up here, and then I say Maven compiler source and target. I say 12. So, and then I have the SDK 12 on my machine and attached to this project here. That is actually it. So let us get started. So I have up here, I've created a package up in my, I have a source folder, main Java, and then I have created a package called, in my case, it's com.codeinvestigator. Then I'll create a new Java class like this. And then we can call it something. The name here, it actually doesn't matter. This is not what we're going to refer to. We're going to give it a name, which is the execution name that we're going to use later on. So this is my weather forecast plugin. Enter. And we're going to extend Mojo. And it's called Abstract Mojo, sorry. Abstract Mojo. Like this. And then we need to implement the methods, and there's one method which is called execute, which makes it very, very simple and very easy to actually use. But of course, as usual, the devil is in the detail. There are two exceptions that can be thrown. One is Mojo execution exception. That is if something fails inside, and then we have the failure exception. That's another kind of exception. That's if we get an unexpected error. This is more like if we can actually throw an expected error. So it gives different results, and Maven will react differently. I think this exception here, it will actually stop the Maven execution. This it could actually continue, and then execute the other plugins and all the other tasks that they need to do. So yeah, so that's the difference. The first thing is the annotation of the module, because we need to give this class a name, and this is execution name, so this is a bit important. So we call this weather forecast today, or tomorrow maybe. Not just weather forecast. This is the weather forecast tomorrow. We need a day. We need a day on it, right? So we need when it is, when it's happening. And then we can give it a default face, and that makes it a bit easier to set up later on, because then I don't need to say which face it should be. And there's a lot of faces here with lifecycle. Not the clean. Let us choose another one. Let's compile, let's deploy, generate resources. We could choose one of the generate sources or resources. Generate resources. Let us use that. So that means that when we're in a generate resources phase, then if we have added this this plugin, and if we have added this execution right here with this name right here, then it will actually run. But we don't need to give the life cycle phase, because this is the default life cycle phase that will be applied if none else is given. And now we need to do some stuff here. And get log. This is something that is on the abstract module. We can get the logger, and then we can actually log stuff out in the console. And that could be we could call this weather forecast tomorrow. Plugin started or begin. Let's call it begin, like this, and maybe three asterisks or stars after that, and also some stars before. So then we can see it actually begins, and then we can actually have an end right there. So, and then we can actually do some stuff down here. Let's say that we actually want to take the forecast. We want to have a parameter. We want an argument to be from outside to be used in a plugin. Then we can use the parameter, and then we can give this a default value, not set. And then we can actually say private string, because this is going to be injected. Prosting, and what should we call this? Forecast like this. And then I can actually print out this forecast here just directly. The forecast for tomorrow is, and then we can actually just print out the parameter that we just got, like this. And that's it, what we're doing in the first situation. Let us just keep it simple. So now we have created a plugin, we have given it an execution name, and we have used a parameter, a set of configuration that we need to set up. Let us try to build this just to see if it works. So that means that I will just write clean install. The clean, it actually deletes the target folder. Install will create it again, and then it will actually install it into the local repository that we have in our home.m2 folder by default. Build success, so it should actually work. So now we should actually place this YAR file in, and we can actually also see where it is, to MNI, my initials, and then .m2 repository, and then it has placed it in on this URL here down here. So we can actually see that it has placed it in the local repository. I know I was covering some of the URL, but it doesn't matter. I'll just drag it out here. Then you can see actually the path. Not that it matters. It just says that it actually placed it inside the local repository, inside this folder here. This is the important part. So now I'm actually happy, but I want to add this plugin to another consumer project right now, or to a consumer project, so we can actually use it somewhere. And one way of the way to do that is actually to remember the, or to copy the group ID, artifact ID, and the version, because we need that in the consumer project. And I just happen to have a consumer project right here. And I wanted a consumer project that is not totally blank. I want a real life example. So what I did was I chose new project, and I chose spring initializer. So we actually got a spring project right here. And then I press next. And then I chose Maven, Maven project, and then I did Java 12, and then I pressed next, and then I ticked off some of the dependencies that I usually use, like Lombok, H2, and the web starter, this one here, and then I press next, and then finish, and also the JPA, I also added the JPA. So I ended up with this project down right here. I've not added any code or anything right here. It is just the default code, and we are not even going to start up the project. It's just so we have a pump file, which looks like a real life example. That's actually what I wanted to. You can see here we have some. If I don't scroll too fast, then we can actually see here I have the dependencies that I chose. They're right here. And that's actually it. So now we would actually like, and we're using Java 12 also here. And we have a parent that's a Spring Boot starter. But let us, let me go down here. Then now I need to add some stuff because we want to use this plugin that we just created. And I'll just copy paste this so we save a bit of time. Copy paste. Plugin, this was a little bit, we need to add, I'll just undo this part, We need to go down to the build. We actually have a build area right here, and we have the plugins. Then we have a plugin already here, and that's a Spring Boot Maven plugin, which helps us set up and build our project and take it in the right dependencies from Spring. So Spring already places this, but we have another plugin we need to add, and that is our own plugin. Code Investigator, demo, Maven plugin forecasts, 1.0 snapshot. Then we can configure it, and here we can place our forecast. Remember the forecast, the name here, this name here, forecasts. It is the same name as we used in our plugin. This value right here. We can also override if you don't like that name or that alias. Then we can actually choose our own alias right here. But per default, it actually takes the variable name right there. So that means that if we set forecast right here, then this member variable will be set with that value. So let's just write something with the snow and rain in the morning. In the morning, later, sunny, and beach weather. So it's shifting a little bit tomorrow. And then we go down to executions. This is important because if you don't fill out these goals here, then nothing is actually, no code is actually run. We need to say that we want to run the execution, and we call that weather forecast tomorrow or something like that. But let me just go copy paste it. This is this name right here, weather forecast tomorrow, copy. Thank you very much. Go back to the consumer project and then we paste it into the goal. Cannot resolve it. Let's just check what happens here. It could not resolve it. That's usually because there's something wrong, of course. But let me just create this Maven, and then I think compile is enough. Then we come to the generate resources lifecycle. Let's just see what happens now here. Oh, it actually works. Okay, IntelliJ cannot find this plugin right here. Let's go up here. Okay, here we have it. Here we have our code. Let me just check that I'm not shading too much for these lines here. I think it looks actually fine. We can see it. So we have weather forecast tomorrow, plugin begin. Right here, the forecast for tomorrow is snow and rain in the morning, later sunny and beach weather. And then we have the end line right here. So it works fine, even though IntelliJ has some problems. Let us just close it and over again. Okay, IntelliJ has some problem with recognizing this, but that's okay. That is okay. Okay, that was step one. We have actually done a lot of things already. We have created a plugin. We have consumed it in another project already. But let us do something a bit more complex. And this is why we needed to have all those dependencies there in our plugin. If I write parameter right here, default value, then I can actually use variables right here. And the variables that I can use is actually documented pretty good on um, on Apache's homepage where they have something called plugin tools, and then Maven plugin tools and annotations. If you go there, then they've actually set, then they've actually listed up all the variables that we can actually use. We can actually take the session, and then we can have a Maven session where we can do, use some of the stuff from there. We can take the Maven project, and then we can then we can get that. And we should actually always read only equals true, because we do not want to set this from the outside. We want to, this to be replaced by parameter or by injection. And also mode your execution. So there's a lot of execution context. There's a plugin descriptor right there, so then we can see something about the descriptor. The usual use case that I'm using the most is actually the base directory or the build directory here. So that means that you can actually get some you can get the directories, and then you can add files. Also, you can also generate some source code. And then it's nice to have the base directory, of course. But what we're going to do is actually we're going to take the project, and then we're going to go for the build, and then the directory, and then we're going to print that out in the console. We're not going to generate any files in this example here. So I'm just going to write project like this. And private Maven project like this, and then project, and let us add another line right here. Project build directory, and then we can actually use the project like this, and then we can choose get. We can actually see here all the stuff that we can get. There's a lot of interesting stuff. We can get all the plugins, and then we would also have listed up the Spring plugin that is used in the consumer project. But let us get the build. Get build dot get output directory. We could also get the source directory. Let us get the output directory, and then let us get output directory. That is fine. Then we have a string to show output. Okay, this is the project build output directory, which is right there. Yes, let us create a clean install on this. We could also just press install. And it's building. Just want to see everything goes as it should. Yes. Everything's fine. Then we go over here, and then we actually Maven. We don't even need to clean. Let us just compile. Then we go to when we do that, then we actually also come to the lifecycle, which is called generate resources. And of course, we can choose the lifecycle that fits all on it. Let us just check here. Here we got the begin. Here we got the forecast. Here we got the project build output directory, and this is exactly. So this is output directory for the classes, target classes. So we're actually happy. Now we actually have the tools, and we have the methods to create our own plugin, and also to consume it in another project. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you liked it, then of course I would appreciate it if you press like, and if you want more content from me, then please subscribe. I hope to see you again very soon. Bye bye.